So my name is Taiwa Weifa. I am a cloud architect with AWS Professional Services. And today, I'm really excited to introduce and present to you a temporary elevated access management solution, which we also call TIM, which we built for AWS Identity Center. Now we're presenting today. The agenda for today is quite straightforward, right? We're going to be starting with the why. Why exactly did we build TIM, and what problem are we trying to address with the solution? However, the bulk of this session will be focused on a demo where we would showcase some of the features and functionalities of TIM, and now you can use it to simplify access management and also improve the security of your AWS environment. And then finally, I would point you to how you can get started, how you can download the solution, deploy it, and implement it within your own environment, right? The idea, the context of this is I'm introducing a new temporary elevated access management solution, which we've built for AWS Identity Center, right? So, as I said, to start, we want to talk about cloud access patterns, right? A lot of organizations today are adopting an automation-first approach, where they're leveraging automation tools, infrastructure as code, and CI/CD pipelines to manage their AWS environment. And as I said, automation is really good, and this is because it allows you to improve scalability, it allows you to ensure consistency. But personally, I think it's very important because it also allows you to improve security by reducing the need for human access, and I think that's quite critical. However, as you might know, we can't simply automate everything today. There's still genuine use cases where we need some form of human access, right? So today, I just want to talk on some of those human access patterns and some use cases where you would need human access to your AWS environment. The first class of users are the cloud center of excellence, right? And in many organizations, they go by so many names. They could call them the platform team or the cloud admins or the system admins. But these folks are generally responsible for managing and looking after your entire AWS estate. And as a result, they typically would need some form of persistent standing access, and in most cases, highly privileged access to enable them to manage your AWS environment. Right? The second user class we want to touch on are the security and incident response team, where this group of users don't necessarily need to have access to all of your AWS accounts at all times, but in the event of a security incident, they must have a feature or a functionality that enables them to access any vulnerable AWS account, remediate them, and then bring them back into compliance. And then finally, we look at the applications team, where this group of users are simply looking for a way to deploy resources in their AWS environment, leveraging a self-service platform, right? And this allows them to focus on business logic that helps to add value to their organizations and businesses, right? So, persistent standing access in itself is not necessarily a bad thing. However, if it's not managed and governed properly, it can lead to some security risk, right? So, for example, a user who has persistent access to a protected resource can invoke multiple sessions to that resource, right, even when it's not required for their business function. The other thing to note here is once your AWS environment starts to scale, it becomes increasingly difficult to manage and to govern access for multiple users and groups and AWS accounts, right? So the question we're trying to address here, or the objective here, is how can we leverage the programmability of the cloud and start to move away from this persistent, always-on access model to a more dynamic, intent-based access without degrading or disrupting user performance, right? And this is exactly why we build TIM. So TIM is an open source solution that is fully integrated with IAM Identity Center and allows you to automate, to manage, and to monitor time-bound elevated access to your multi-account AWS environment at scale. As I said previously, it's a custom solution that you can download from the AWS open source repo, and then you can deploy within your environment. The key message here is that TIM enables organizations to be able to ensure that users are only granted access to protected resources when it is required and only for a specific time or duration. And this would help to reduce the risk of unauthorized access and improve the security of your AWS environment. So let's look at a typical workflow or use case for the team solution, right? AWS best practice recommends that you have you segment workloads into different accounts depending on their security requirements. And the implementation of this is that most organizations would have multiple production accounts and non-production accounts. Today, we can use IAM Identity Center to manage access into your AWS environment. A quick show of hands, how many people are using IAM Identity Center today? Perfect. It looks like we have a lot of people. So on the flip side, how many people are not using Identity Center today? Is there a reason why? All right, cool. So the scenario we're looking at today is there's a developer who has some form of persistent access into a development account. And this allows them to do experimentation, to test new features and functionalities. However, they don't have access to a production account. So in the case of an incident in a production account, the developer should be able to log in into the team application and request for elevated access. And they can do this by providing information about the business justification as well as the duration when they need the access for. Now, an approver can then log in into the team application and approve the request. And once this is done, team would orchestrate and automate the process of assigning the permission sets and the accounts to that particular user in Identity Center. Now, the developer can invoke access into the production account and then fix the problem. So when the duration expires, the duration requested for, the team orchestration workflow would then remove the elevated access. And now, if the developer tries to invoke a new session into that production account, it wouldn't work. They won't be able to do it. And then finally, an auditor can log in into the team application and get historical information and current information about all elevated access requests, as well as look at the session activity that was performed during the period of elevated access. So they say a picture paints a thousand words. So without further ado, I'm going to show you a quick demo of how it looks. And bear with me, I'll switch my camera now. Let's go back to the scenario we talked about earlier, right? We have a developer who has been assigned a ticket to resolve an issue inside of a production account. And right now, they are logged into Identity Center, which I hope a lot of you are familiar with. And here you can see that they've got some form of persistent access to a dev account, but not a production account, right? So for them to request elevated access to the production accounts, they would have to sign in into the team application, which has been configured as a custom SAML 2.0 application in Identity Center. Now, this will single sign on the developer into the team application which we've built. Now, a glance at this, you would assume that this is the AWS management portal, but it is not, right? This is a custom application that you would download and implement in your environment. We made a conscious decision to make the UI very familiar so that you would have a seamless experience that you're already familiar with, right? So now, if the developer needs to create the request, it would go to the Create Request tab. So it would go to the Create Request tab, and here it needs to fill in information about the account, the role, the duration, and the justification for which it needs the access for, right? So now, if you see, when it clicks on the drop-down, it will see something which is important. It says, there is no eligible account, neither is there an eligible permission, right? This is because of a very important concept called eligibility, which is a form of pre-authorization that defines what account and role a user can request access for in the first place. And this can only be configured by an admin of the team application. So now, we will switch over to the admin persona, and pay attention to the rightmost tab. Here you can see that that says admin, right? And that's an admin column there. But also, on the navigation tab, you would see that we've got a new pane which says administration. And here you can configure the eligibility policy. Here, I would add the policy for the developer. I would select my user. And all of this information, by the way, is gotten from your Identity Center database. Now I'll select the developer. I'll select accounts I want them to have access to. In this case, I'll say I want them to be able to access the production account. And maybe I also want them to be able to access all the accounts in the security OU, right? And I could also specify I would want them to be able to assume the power user and also the read-only role. I can also specify a maximum duration and say I need them to be able to access for 10 hours, right? But then this last bit is very important, right? Because remember the security incident response team I talked about earlier. Time is of the essence. You don't want them to be waiting for an approval before they get the access. So yeah, you can toggle off the requirement for approval, and now the security response team would not need any form of approval before they get access. But for this case, we want them to go through the approval process, right? And now we can click on add eligibility. Here you see that the eligibility has been added. And if we switch back to the developer view, and we try to create the request again, now you would see that the developer can then request access for the production account and also all the accounts in the security OU. We'll select the production account here, and we'll say we want to assume the power user role. We can also select a start time. We say we can either start the session now, or we can schedule this for some time in the future. But for this demo, we'll say we need the access right now. We add a duration and say, for this case, we want 3 hours. And we can then tie this back to our incident management ticket system. But most importantly, we want to provide a business justification. So yeah, so now we've requested for the access. You can see all of the details here. Now we're switching over to the approver. First thing that happens in the workflow is a group of approvers, we get an email notification, right, that they need to approve the elevated access request, and they can log in into the team application again, right? Now you can see on the rightmost side that I'm logged in as an approver, and if I want to approve the request, I'll go to approve request. I can select that request by the developer and decide if I want to approve or reject it. In this case, we want to approve it. And I can add some extra metadata on the reason why I'm approving it. And then I'll click on confirm. Once this is done, a couple of actions is triggered in the backend again. Now I'll switch back to the developer view. And now you can see that the request has changed from pending to approved. Right. The developer also gets an email notification letting them know that the request has been approved. And when the elevated access duration starts, they also get a notification. Now, the developer switches back to the team application. And if they go to Identity Center, they log into Identity Center now. The developer will see, voila, I could see not just the dev account, right? But I could now also see that I've got access to the production account. I could then log in via the command line or through the management console to fix the issues with that particular environment. So what would happen is the developer logs in, fix the problem, and after 3 hours, the team automation workflow would then remove that permission again. But I trust that you can't wait for 3 hours, so there's an alternative. There's something else we can do. Let's assume the developer had finished fixing the problem before 3 hours. They can actually go back to the team application, right? In the elevated access tab, they could view the details and they can see all the information that the request is in progress. It would expire in less than 3 hours, but they can also then revoke the access and say, I don't need this access any longer because I fixed the issue in less than 3 hours. And this can be done by not just the user, but it can be done by the approver as well. So now we're revoking the access. We can add some comments if we want to. And then we confirm this. Again, what would happen in the back end is that the automation workflow will remove that permission from that user. And now, if the developer goes back to Identity Center, they would see that now they only have access to the dev account and no longer to the production account. The last persona I want to introduce is the auditor. right? So an auditor can also log in into the team application. Again, pay attention to the rightmost tab. You can see this person is logged in as an auditor. They can see an extra view on the navigation which says audit. And then this allows them to see all the historical and current information of elevated access, right? So you can see everything that has happened within the organization. You can also see elevated access that has either ended or has been revoked. And what the auditor can do, they can, let's take one of them for example, we can view the details, and this is quite powerful, right? The auditor can see all the information of why it was requested, why it was approved, but most importantly, they can see all the session activity logs of what that person did from the start time to the end time of the elevated access, right? And now they can start to correlate the business justification with the actions which was actually performed. This is searchable, and you can also then download this as a CSV file for further investigation. Cool. That's the end of the demo, but I'll just do a quick recap of what we've shown you so far. We've shown you the team solution. You can use it to request for access. We've shown you how the automation workflow works. We've explained the concept of eligibility, and we've also shown you a very critical component, how you can use the team solution to audit what actions were performed during the period of elevated access. So yeah, there's a couple of outcomes here. As you can see, this would help us to simplify access management, right? We're moving away from that persistent access model to a more dynamic, intent-based access model, right? And overall, it's going to help to improve the security of your AWS environment. We don't have too much time, but tomorrow we have a chalk talk where we'll dive deeper into this particular solution. We'll show you how we built it. We'll show you what the solution components are. But if you can't make it, we've also, if you can take a snapshot of this URL, this will take you to a blog post which we recently released that gives you information about how to deploy the solution, how to download it. And all of the documentation is in there. So I recommend you to download this. But again, I invite you tomorrow for the chalk talk. Please come along where we'll dive deep and we'll have enough time to explore the solution. So yeah, that's my talk. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you find this very insightful. But yeah, I can't stay for questions, but if you have any questions, you can come around and ask me. But again, I encourage you to come around for the chalk talk tomorrow. Thank you so much, guys.